get ready to experience the Changing Earth audio drama, brought to you by an incredible lineup of podcasters and survivalists from across the country, including listeners like you.
Twisted Fate.
Finally done. Good morning, girls. You two are here early.
We're running Santa through her field test today.
She's a beautiful horse. I bet she's gonna do great.
What you doing out here?
I love horses too, you know. I used to sleep on a hammock in a stall next to my horse when I was a girl. It's a peaceful way to start the day. Did Daniel go with Crystal and Carmen to school?
Of course. Mitchell had them all ready to go. He loves being a daddy. Smiles from ear to ear. The kids are pumped about diving lessons from Craig this afternoon.
He's good. I actually did a flip off the diving board the other day. I never thought I'd have the courage to do it.
Craig has a way of giving you confidence. It's amazing.
One of his finer qualities, I'd say. Sorry to cut this short, but Bennett will be pissed if I'm late.
Don't keep him waiting on our account.
Good luck with Sandy.
Who is it?
Recruit more, sir. Permission to enter, sir?
Granted, and it's about time. Did you get all the saddles cleaned?
Yes, sir.
Tomorrow, you can do the gym mats and the equipment.
Yes, sir.
I want you to go inform Recruit Fisher that we need 2 material salvage squad members for the next mission.
Yes, sir, but Bennett was expecting me.
You'll have to double your training session tomorrow. You're also going to have to find replacements on your squad for recruits Penny Sherman, Harold Duncan, and your mother.
Yes, sir. I'll discuss it with Bennett.
Good. After lunch, report to the gate for refugee check-in.
Yes, sir.
You're dismissed.
Thank you, sir. Freaking asshole. And now I'll be in trouble with Bennett. His newest plateau is graying for ghosts.
First private, lead the class.
Yes, sir.
Nice of you to show up, Cupcake.
Commander Burns said we'll have to double up tomorrow.
Don't worry about that. We will.
He has me running errands all day, and I'm stationed to check in after lunch, sir.
He still got you doing early morning cleaning details?
Yeah, it's not so bad, sir. I haven't seen my family and friends as happy in a while. It makes it worth it.
Good way to look at it.
Commander Burns said I need to find replacements for my mom, Penny, and Harold, sir.
Already done. I wanted to talk to you about Dexter, though.
What's the problem, sir?
He's a fine fighter and performing as expected, but his drill sergeant says he's shifty and unpredictable.
That's weird.
I was wondering if you knew what was going on.
I haven't seen much of him.
Go do what you gotta do, Hopscotch. But you better get your butt in here tomorrow.
Yes, sir. Morning, Roxy. Is my mom around?
Oh, yeah. She's around somewhere.
You tired?
Don't tell anyone,
But one of the soldiers took me to this new club last night. The party was off the chain.
And your mother would be off the chain angry if she knew you were out there, Roxy.
I know, but I couldn't resist. I heard so many of the soldiers talking about it.
Probably not the best idea, Roxy.
Don't give her too much hassle. She gets plenty of that from Mom and Dad.
That's why I love working here. Plus, look at this great outfit I'm making.
Wow, that's a beautiful dress.
I know you're not here to look at dresses. What's up?
Commander Burns wants two material scavenge members for the next mission.
Two? Okay. Hopefully they'll bring home some good stuff.
Probably. You going to lunch soon?
No. I'm in the middle of some projects. I have to finish them up before then.
I'll see you tonight. Love you, Mom.
Love you too, hon.
Erika, how's it going?
Better than you. Looks like you have your hands full.
Yeah, but at least they're clean and no lice. Remember living in that place? Half the children were bald. And I even thought about shaving my own head once or twice.
Good times.
And I can't believe the people just keep coming. Can you imagine living in there now?
We sure got lucky.
Yeah, we did. Jason, don't put that in your mouth. Oh, crap. I'll see you later.
Bye.
Over here.
Star! Eating alone?
I am. Ron's out of town today.
You two are getting pretty serious, huh?
I don't know. He's a nice guy and fun to hang out with.
How come he never got adopted out?
His parents died in the quake. It was just him. He enjoyed training for the military and decided that was the life he wanted.
But you don't?
I don't know. Things are going well here. I just got a promotion. I'm going to be the field chef for the commander.
Nice! At least he recognizes good cooking. God knows he doesn't recognize a job well done.
What do you mean?
It's nothing. That's awesome you got the job.
It's cool. I got to ride in the private transport. No more smelly buses. So is Dad going to be able to make it to Daniel's party?
They better let him have the whole day off.
Rob said he's been working some crazy hours with Dad so he could fill in.
Dad's been raving about that kid. And he's stronger than an ox.
How did a kid like that come from Harold and Betsy?
Harold got the brains and his son got the brawn.
Isn't that the truth?
Well, I'm off. Time to check in at the refugee center.
Every day, more and more people come. Where are they all going?
It has to be getting tight in there, that's for sure. But large shipments are going to the central region for building projects.
Oh, that's interesting.
I just work here. Hopefully we'll be back out on mission soon. I'll see you later.
Bye, Mom. I love you.
I love you, too. Don't stay out too late. I worry.
I won't.
There's an evil entity out here in interstellar space, playing marbles with the planet. It's standing right behind me. I know that it is there. But when I turn to face it, it has vanished.
What's the problem now?
Look at all the people, DJ.
The Ogallala collapse. It'll be chaos from here on home.
Seems to me. There's a bit more to it than that.
We're in Vernon, right?
We are. Only a few more miles before we hit the central region.
Pull over and find a parking spot. Let's go get a drink.
I don't know, DJ. There's only two of us to guard you.
We have to get the lay of the land. I'll be discreet.
Okay, DJ.
Lock down the truck. I don't want the boys in the back getting antsy.
Yes, DJ.
Jeff's soft and sweet as summer wind blows, the floorboards creak out a beat.
We need a bottle of whiskey and vodka.
Sir, we're running low. It's gonna cost you.
I'm sure this will do.
A pass from Colonel Henderson? That will do just fine, sir.
Sergey.
Anthony?
What are you doing here?
Hoping against all odds to find you, sir.
Let's go to the table, boys.
What are you talking about, Anthony?
Malik shut down his borders. He said TJ was dead. He confiscated the 2 truckloads from Mexico, and Ryan's team's being held as ransom.
That arrogant bastard.
Mr. Lee sent me down here to search for you, or get news of what happened.
I'm going to string him up, Angie.
Right now, we have to worry about getting home. Our team is too small to fight his army.
What has Commander Gray had to say about all this?
With everyone thinking you're dead, it's hard to know what to do. Commander Gray had to negotiate with Malik without you.
Unbelievable.
TJ, calm down. Low profile, remember?
Gray is in charge of the police force not moving people, and Henderson needs those people. Cut him some slack.
Some slack? I'm gone for a couple of weeks and suddenly I'm dead, and Gray's forming new alliances.
Gray sent scouts out everywhere looking for you. It's Malik filling his head with lies.
Then let's go get that piece of garbage and teach him what true pain really is.
DJ, we need to see Mr. Lee. He's probably going out of his mind right now. Think this through, comrade. We can regroup, resupply. Let Gray know you're still alive, and hit Malik with the full force of both armies.
Then Malik will be all yours. You'll have him groveling at your feet in no time.
I do like the sound of that.
All we need to do is figure out a way to get you through Malik's territory.
If we go around, it's going to take another week to get home.
That's my thought as well.
Then we go through. We can take the guard patrols.
No, DJ. If they find out you're alive, we'd put ourselves in even more danger. I saw a rowboat on the lake. Yuri and I will get you home.
What about Anthony and the fighters in the transport?
They stay here. That way we can coordinate an attack from both sides when we come back.
What are we waiting for? Let's go.
You've been talking with Monroe a lot lately.
His wife is pregnant. There's a lot of plans to be made.
That's true, but it's more than that.
What do you want me to say, Major? You're looking for something.
I've always been honest with you. I've kept secrets for you. I've protected this little town from the feds for you. All I want is for you to return the gesture.
We may have to discuss more than just the pregnancy.
Is he planning to leave? You understand this is breaking my heart, right?
Then let him go.
I can't. If one of my top men goes AWOL, I'd lose my position here. That puts you and every free town in the West in jeopardy. If I have to sacrifice the one for the many, then that's what I have to do. My hands are tied.
People have the right to be free.
I agree, but some of us are in too deep for that option to be reality. Monroe is one of those men. If I would have known sooner what his plans were, I could have prevented all this, but now...
The plans are already in motion.
Yep. I just needed to hear it from you.
What are you going to do?
What I have to. Like I said, my hands are tied.
What's the plan, sir?
I want you to take a team and put Ginger in custody. Do it discreetly.
Yes, sir.
Put that board over there.
Monroe, put the first private in charge and walk with me.
You heard the man, Jessup. Take over.
Yes, sir.
What's going on, sir?
Put these on.
Handcuffs? Is this a joke, sir?
Unfortunately, it's not.
What if I refuse?
Then I'll have to call the guards over and make a scene.
But, sir...
Put on the cuffs, Monroe. Follow the order. Do it now.
Ginger.
Put them on.
Yes, sir.
Ginger is already in custody. We're taking you two down to Vegas camp tomorrow.
How can you do this?
I talked with Dolores. She confirmed your plans to leave.
Chappie told you, didn't he?
Of course he did. You know what kind of position I would be in if you deserted us. I would lose my position, and that would put everyone in the Western region at risk. I can't let that happen. You forced my hand.
I should have never told that son of a bitch.
No, Monroe. You should have never made the decision to leave. We were a team. We've always been a team.
But now I'm going to be a father.
Wrong. Now you're going to be a refugee father. Enjoy your son, because you won't be having another. I can't believe you would throw everything away.
I can't share a cell with Ginger?
No. We'll see you in the morning.
Why did I run? I should know better. It was dark, and I was in love, or whatever. It could have meant to be. It could be meant to be. It should be meant to be. Just you and me, why did I...
Please enjoy a quick word from our sponsors.
Are you worried about how dangerous the world has become in these days of terrorist attacks, natural disasters, or even a future collapse? You need to be medically prepared to keep your family safe. I'm Joe Alton, MD of store.doomandbloom.net, where you'll find an entire line of uniquely designed medical kits and supplies for when help is not on the way. For everything from individual first aid kits to the ultimate family medical bag, go to store.doomandbloom.net today. You'll be glad you did.
Prepper Broadcasting Network is 9 dynamic hosts, 7 podcasts a week, live shows, chat rooms, daily updates, all on prepping, survival, and patriotism. Visit PrepperBroadcasting.com for your dose of self-reliance and independence.
Hi, this is Jane Austen, otherwise known as Survivor Jane, and the voice of Dolores Chapman. I'd like to invite you to my website, SurvivorJane.com, where I write in a conversational tone on topics of how better to prepare yourself and family. You can also find links to my books, What Could Possibly Go Wrong, Emergency Survival Hygiene, and my game book, Puzzling Over Preparedness. You can also find information on Prepper Camp, the largest 3-day preparedness event in the country every fall, hosted by myself and my husband, Rick Austin.
Disaster Coffee is fueling disaster relief in America. Our coffee is roasted to order and shipped to your front door. You cannot get it any fresher. Visit disastercoffee.com and caffeinate with a purpose. That's disastercoffee.com. And now back to the Changing Earth audio drama.
He said no?
He said no. Daniel is a mess. Some birthday, huh? I gotta go to the bathroom.
We can have another party with your friends from the camp, baby. How about that?
It won't be the same thing, Mom. I wanted them to come here and see the pool. Matthew said...
Calm down, buddy. What did Matthew say?
Matthew said they were too dirty. We couldn't have anyone swimming in mud. He said there were scuzzy people who didn't belong here. They're my friends, Mom.
I know, honey. I know. They're your friends, and it's not fair.
And they're not scuzzy.
They're not scuzzy. Come here. You'll get to see your friends from school.
I hate those kids from school. And they hate me. They call me a dirty refugee and throw spitballs at me in class. They're just coming because of Greg and his diving lessons.
It's still new, baby. They're all still adjusting. Things will get better. You'll make new friends.
You just don't get it, Mom. I don't want to fit in. Can't fit in. My friends lost their homes just like we did. The kids at school think the refugees are animals. They even say so. I can't, Mom. I just can't.
Well, son, I don't know what to tell you, except that I love you just the way you are. You just keep on being you. But we're going to your party tonight, and we're going to have fun, me and you together. You just relax and calm down. How long have you been there, Dex?
Long enough. What did you do, Mom?
I didn't do anything, Dex. Matthew told him his friends from the camp couldn't come to the party.
I know. I heard your conversation. I meant, what did you do about it? What did you tell Matthew?
Nothing, Dex. Dad took him. What could I do? He's a superior.
He's a superior? He's a freaking turd, Mom. If you're not going to do anything, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am. What the heck, Dad?
You will not treat your mother like that, ever. Do you understand me, boy? Do you? We are a family, a team. We make decisions together. We stand together and we survive together. And that is it. Without one another, we are done.
Then tell me, who my mother is now? Just a few months ago, you would have been in Matthew's face. You would have stood up to him and told him about the injustices of his actions. You would have fought for those people down there in the camp. What happened to you, Mom? Where did you go?
I did this for us. To get us out of that hole. We spent 9 years as prisoners clawing for scraps. I saw a way out, and I took it. Now look. We have food and purpose and freedom.
Freedom? I don't think so. Living in that hole, we had more freedom. We're just better fed prisoners now. We have been silenced, and now there's no one to speak up for the people.
Why me, Dex? Why do I need to be the one to sacrifice my life and that of my family for them? No one else wanted to stand and face the consequences. Why should I?
Why not you, Mom? I always believed in you, but this? My, what a fancy sell it took to silence your protests and finally extinguish your fire.
Now you stop it right there. I did this for us, for Daniel. He never knew life outside that pit. He deserves better.
Way to go, Mom. It really looks like he's enjoying his new life. He's not even allowed to paint. But then, I guess you didn't know that. Too busy impressing the superiors to spend time with your kids.
Stop it, Dexter. It's not Mom's fault. Just stop it.
Whoa, what's going on in here?
We're just filling Mom in on how great life is here.
Oh.
You knew too, Star? Why didn't you guys tell me what was going on?
I talked to Dad.
What? Oh, I get it. You guys didn't tell me anything. Just let me go on believing everybody was happy and life was good. Then when it all blows up, you blame me for not doing anything about it?
Now that's not how it happened, baby.
Don't you baby me right now, Bits. You knew about all of this. You knew all along and didn't tell me. What about no secrets?
It's not like that.
Really? Then tell me what it's like.
We all knew the pride you had to swallow to be here. We all knew you did it for us. We thought you were happy now, and no one wanted to upset that.
A lot of good it did for me.
Not his fault, Mom. I told him not to tell you.
Then how can you stand there and wonder what happened to me? You all knew exactly what happened, and you helped create it.
All right. Let's just slow down. We've all kept secrets from one another. We really need to face that.
I haven't been keeping any secrets.
Really, Mom? Then why have you been putting in all those extra hours cleaning gear all morning before training? It's because of the guy you killed on our first operation, right? Failure to follow orders to the T, right?
What? That's why you leave so early? They have you cleaning gear because you killed a guy to save that jerk-off soldier?
How did you know, Star?
Ron told me. He said he saw you cleaning the cage one morning. So now it's out on the table. Daniel is living in peer pressure hell. Dexter is miserable working for a system he doesn't believe in. I walk around all day with soldiers whooping at me like I'm a refugee whore. Dad is torn between operations he doesn't want to go on and gardens he loves in a miserable refugee camp. And you swallow your spirit and ambition every day to pay dues for something you did with the best intentions in mind.
There's only one thing left to do. Hug it out.
Oh.
How sweet.
All right, guys, we're out of here.
We're with you.
But for now, we have a party to get ready for.
Everywhere I'm turning, I'm seeing more and more of the same. We all blame each other, but no one ever wants to explain. I don't know the answer, but I sure as hell ain't left no dead. I'm tired.
TJ, it's very good to see you, sir.
I hope you've been holding down the fort while I've been gone.
We've been trying, sir.
I bet you have. Let's go see Mr. Lee.
He's in his office with Laudna.
I won't keep him waiting. Do me a favor, Nate.
Yes, sir.
Go and get Commander Gray, but do not tell him I'm alive. Tell him Mr. Lee needs to see him right now.
Yes, sir.
TJ, my son, it's about damn time you got home. You're late, as usual.
I'm sorry, Mr. Lee. The center of the country collapsed, and Malik decided to grow a backbone.
Sit down, son. Have a drink with me.
I'm honored as usual, sir.
As am I. The reports were you died. Some said in the collapse, and others said that Malik's men took you. I sent scouts anyway.
Anthony found us and warned us. Malik did send his men, but you know that no one can take me down, Mr. Lee. You train me to be the most powerful fighter in the world.
It's true, son. That's why I sent the scouts.
I want Malik on my wall.
And you'll have him, son.
His men hit the caravan and took the men. They caught up to me in Texas, flipped our truck.
Why weren't you with the caravan?
Jose asked me to secure a supply of people from Vegas.
Did you?
The captain in charge is a bargaining man.
We'll have to figure out how to get them across the Ogallala.
That's the last thing on the list. Jose is sending two more transports within a week, and I assured him the route would be safe for his crews.
Then we make sure it is.
Commander Gray is here.
Send him in.
Holy shit. Is that you, TJ?
You thought a putz like Malik could take me out? You think so little of me, Commander?
I should have known better.
You should have. Malik failed, and I think it's time for Malik to meet Sheila.
I'll need a couple of weeks to coordinate the attack.
He took two of my transports of men. He has Ryan and a team of my black shirts in a cell. I have two more transports of men coming up in a week. All of those refugees were for their colonel. So you tell me how long it's going to take to get your force together.
Damn, TJ. You did good.
And you let everything fall apart in a matter of weeks.
Maybe you didn't get the notice, but the Ogallala collapsed. I thought you were dead, and I had my hands full.
Maybe I didn't notice. Yuri and Sergey just rode a boat all the way up to northern end of that new lake. Then we scaled a 100-foot cliff to make it back here. And you think I didn't notice?
I'm sorry, TJ. Just give me a minute to think.
I can have half of our full force mobilized in 2 days.
And I can do the same. Besides, what he did to you, he's clearly overreaching his bounds. I'll make the case to the colonel. He wants those people to finish the wall. He'll agree.
He better, or mobilizing without the feds. That man is mine, and I will have him, one way or another.
He's yours. I need to speak with the colonel. It's damn good to see you, TJ.
Please enjoy a quick word from our sponsors.
Hey everyone, this is Phil Rabley from the Matter of Facts podcast, voicing the role of Cole Virgis. If prepping guns and politics sounds like your cup of tea, come check out the Matter of Facts podcast every Friday on iTunes, Stitcher, and Spotify with my co-host, Andrew Bobo.
L. Douglas Hogan here, doing the voice of Swenson. You can also hear me on all major podcasting platforms at The Rising Republic. I'm also on YouTube, The Rising Republic Video Bites. I'll see you guys over there, and you have a marvelous day.
Hey, fellow patriots, Bravo Echo here. Are you paying attention to what is happening in our great nation? Are you prepared? If not, come see us at hopeforsurvival.com. That's hopeforsurvival.com. Be safe and be blessed.
Here on the homestead, we'd like to keep it simple. That's why we created Stasis, your resource for the highest quality freeze-dried apples direct from the source. All of our fruits are hand-picked, hand-processed, and hand-packaged just for you. This is a variety of freeze-dried foods unlike anything you've ever tasted before. Find out more at stasis.vip.
And now back to the Changing Earth audio drop.
I hope you're real proud of yourself, Chappie. How's it feel to see your friend and his pregnant wife in chains because of your big mouth? You're not going to say anything?
Stow it, Monroe. Time for talking is over.
Good to see you, Major.
I wish it were under different circumstances.
Sometimes good men go bad. Nothing can be done about it.
Maybe so, but these two are special to me.
We usually start them out in the welcome warehouse and survey them for behavior before they're released.
Screw you, Chappie. You knew what would happen.
So did you? It was your decision.
I thought I could trust you.
Monroe, get off him. You'll kill him.
I'll kill you, too.
Put him in restraints. You okay, Major Virgis?
I'm fine.
The female can go into general population, but he is going into the box.
I understand. I never thought.
It's like I said, Major. Sometimes good men go bad.
I guess so.
You and your men are more than welcome to stay for the night. You know where the guest quarters are.
Thank you, Captain.
Everything about that felt wrong.
We did what we had to do. Let's go find Alex.
When I started it all, I had you to walk. But it was different than the town before. When I started it all,
this place is hopping.
Where there's food, there's people.
I could sure go for some of that.
When I started it all, I needed a home.
Major, isn't that Erika over at the refugee check-in?
It is. Somehow we have to get our whole family out. That's going to be the trick.
Make the days. Make sure I didn't waste what was there.
Major Virgis.
Just the man I was looking for.
I heard you brought in Monroe. What happened?
Just got a table in a quiet corner.
Sounds good.
Can I get you gentlemen some food? Some drink?
I'll have a beer and the chicken dinner.
I'll have the same.
Coming right up, gentlemen.
Monroe is going to desert the forces. Ginger is pregnant. He wanted to be a father, not a soldier.
You can do both.
He didn't see it that way. You know the feds are pushing to have me removed and destroy the free towns.
If Monroe left, it would give them an excuse.
I couldn't let that happen.
Here you go, gentlemen.
Thank you. I've been out to see General McClintock. He wants to go forward with the Erika plan.
I think that is a good choice. She deserves a shot.
Well, she's gonna get it. The militia are out. After what happened with William, they want nothing to do with her. But they will help get Cassidy out. I told them I was going to get them both at once.
Jeez, Virgis, that's a tall order.
I know, but it had to be done. The militia has refugees on the inside. We can use them to provide distraction.
But you know you can't just take Erika. You're gonna get the whole family out. And they're spread all over the place.
Plus, I can't be here. We can't give the feds an excuse to take the West or turn on the Merc forces.
We're going to need a miracle, my friend.
I'll help while I'm here and coordinate my people on the inside. But it's well known Cassidy visits me. I can't be here when she escapes. It would raise too many questions.
I have a handful of people. We'll see what we can put together. Anything is possible. Together we are unstoppable. You can turn the devil back to hell. War and peace, here to love the sick made well. Now what are you going to do to make sure your dreams come true?
Well, hello. Anyone home? Where's your head today, Cupcake? I wanted to show you something, but you checked out a long time ago.
I don't know what's wrong, Sergeant.
Seems like you're chasing 100 different demons around in there. Focus, woman. Oh. There's my girl. But you should have finished it off. Having your mommy leave couldn't have messed with your head that bad. Come on. See, you have to finish it.
Yes, sir. It's not because my mom left with Brett. That's almost a good thing. And it is, but it's not.
I knew it, but what? Come with me. We're not getting anything done today anyway.
Yes, sir. Are we going to see Vince? I guess not. What are we doing here? I don't want to...
Walk. Go!
Oh my gosh, the smell, Sergeant. It haunts my dreams. I've never seen the hallways. I always had a hood on.
Come here.
Who's in there? It's the woman from the pit. Why is she here?
I'm gonna kill that bitch! You can't stop me! I'm gonna find her and I'm gonna fucking kill her!
Oh.
I got this, First Private.
Yes, sir.
Be back in 30 minutes.
Yes, sir.
Sit down.
Why did you bring me here? So I could feel guilty about what I had to do?
Absolutely not. You know how I feel. If they are in our way, they have to go. I would have done the same in your position and probably taken a few more with them.
Then why?
You needed to see it from this side. This is where it all started. This is where I found a woman so full of fire that I thought you would never be able to control it. But then you calmed. Years later, when I had the opportunity to train you, I thought it would never work. You were stubborn and strong and performed better than I expected. And somewhere along the way, I came to respect and love you.
What?
Just shut up. I don't mean it like that. I mean, like a little sister, a friend, something I haven't had for a long, long time. When I first met you, you had more fire than that girl in there that hates your guts. I thought we had to extinguish the flame, but now I'm not so sure that was the best idea.
What are you trying to say, Sergeant?
I'm trying to say I looked at your file with Matthew the other day. You were still slotted as a refugee, and your boy is still slotted for the procedure. There's no cameras here. They don't want the outside world to know what goes on here, but I do, and you do.
Are you serious? They're still going to fuck with Daniel after everything I've done?
That's why I had to tell you. I don't know why, but I did. And I have something else to tell you.
What?
You have to get out of here. You have to take your family and run as far and as fast as you can. You won't be able to trust anyone out there, but you have to try anyway. You and your family are strong enough to make it. You will die if you stay here, and it will be a slow, miserable death.
As soon as we get the chance, we were planning on leaving anyway. We just haven't figured out how yet.
Good.
Come with us, Sergeant.
You know I can. I have my place here. I like it here. I don't have a family. I can help the people here. Do I get a hug?
Aw, man, you're all sweaty.
Pit stop.
Oh, that's nasty.
Come on, let's get out of here.
With pleasure.
You're cold and on the inside. I see it when you breathe.
Thank you, Erica.
Thank you, sir. Please enjoy a quick word from our sponsors.
Hey everyone, this is Dale and Lisa from SurvivalistPrepper.net. I played the voice of Lautner.
And I played the voice of Carol and Star.
Over at Survivalist Prepper, we have the podcast, and I also have a new podcast that I'm doing with Brian Duff called The Duff and Dale Show.
And you can find me on my YouTube channel, The Budget Equestrian.
Hi, this is Sarah F. Hathaway, the creator of the Changing Earth series and the voice of Erica Moore. Visit ChangingEarthSeries.com to explore the novels behind the drama and the survival knowledge behind the stories. Join the Changing Earth membership program and get 1 week early access to the show. We appreciate you helping the Changing Earth world go round. Visit us at www.ChangingEarthSeries.com. That's www.ChangingEarthSeries.com.
Hello, everyone out there in Internet Radio Land. This is Dave Jones, the NBC guy. And have I got a deal for you? Everybody that listens to Sarah's audio drama gets a special deal from me on Mira safety products. These are top quality protective gear used by armies around the world. You can only get that deal by emailing me at NBCguy@protonmail.com.
I'm quite concerned about what's coming next. Personally, I think we'll probably see food shortages and other disruptions. Are you prepared if things go wrong? Does your family have enough food and supplies on hand to last at least 30 days? If not, the time to prepare is right now. Don't wait another minute. To help you on your journey, I recommend My Patriot Supply. They're the leaders in self-reliance, and they have a 4-week supply of emergency food that lasts up to 25 years in storage, so you never have to worry again. Don't put your family through the pain of hunger or standing in government food lines. Go to preparewithchangingearth.com today, and your emergency food will be shipped quickly and discreetly to your door. Those who know what's coming are using today to prepare. So visit preparewithchangingearth.com, the original Patriot Preparedness Company. Their mission is your survival. That's preparewithchangingearth.com. And now back to the Changing Earth audio drama.
Nobody kills Malik. I want him alive.
I think those guards at the gates just cheat themselves.
I told him he did not want this fight.
Easy pickings, DJ.
I want minimal casualties. Round up the fighters. We'll take them home and break them.
Let me go to the front, DJ. I want to see some action.
I'm going to. Come on, Sergey.
DJ, my brother, do not go.
Don't tell me.
No, DJ. Not today. If you were ever going to listen to me, listen today. Please.
Go, Yuri. Get some for me.
This is where we have to funnel into two streets.
Radio to Anthony. Have him come in from the back. Put our snipers on the roof. Where's Nate's team at?
They should be in position right about now. He went in hours ago to get his spot quiet.
He's got more patience than I do. It's that little building right over there.
That's the one he picked.
Smart man. Not the obvious place, but still a good shot.
It's where I'm going, DJ.
Yuri went left, so we're going right. We'll pinch them with our forces. Keep Gray's forces back to secure the city behind us.
Press it! Keep eyes on those buildings!
What? Overhead.
The smoke of people. Burning dead. They gave their lives for this war. Because their leaders wanted more.
We're almost there.
I'm in position now, sir. Permission to...
Press forward.
TJ, what y'all?
A pitfall trap? That crafty bastard. You saved my life, Sergey.
But where's Yuri?
Yuri. Yuri. Yuri, come in, Yuri. Hold tight. We're coming to get you. You men there, get those jeeps up here. Drive them out into the pit, one after another, to form a bridge.
Yes, sir.
And make it fast.
Yes, sir.
Come on, Sergey. Our team's going after Yuri.
You heard them. Let's go.
Yes, sir.
Now's our chance.
Here he is, DJ. Down the alley.
Nice to see you, brothers.
Have you heard any word from Nate?
Nothing since the explosion.
Let's finish this. Door.
TJ, sir.
Looks like you got it all wrapped up in here.
Anthony's in the office.
Anthony Gerber. Come here often?
Can't say that I do, sir. But I knew how much you wanted this bastard in chains.
Horrors! Oh, for a second! Please, TJ, don't!
Job well done, Anthony.
I'm a little worse for wear, sir. But pain is your friend.
Malik, you will come to love this day. Because it's the day your lessons in pain will begin.
You got your boy?
He's coming home with me. You got a man picked to replace him and secure the town?
Everything is already in motion.
The Colonel thanks your men for their sacrifice to secure the Republic.
Just make sure that route stays secure, and that will be thanks enough. Sergei, report.
We found Nate. The blast threw him clear of the building. The med team is taking him home. Ryan and our men have been retrieved. We're rounding up the fighters now.
Excellent. Put him in a box, and I'll unwrap him when I get home.
Not a problem, brother.
Damn, Virgis. You can't sneak up in the dark like that. You're gonna get yourself shot.
I'm leaving in the morning and we have to talk.
Let's go get a drink.
I don't know that we should be seen together.
What do you need to talk about?
Erika.
What about her?
The Mercs gave me permission to use my resources to get her out of here.
Then take her legally. She's a refugee.
She's not.
Are we talking about the same Erika?
The lone survivor?
But...
General McClintock cross-referenced the federal databases. She's not hard to track.
She's been here for 9 years. Why didn't anyone... Her children.
Landowner children. Do you know what a mistake like that would do to a FEMA director's career?
The board would strip his authority and throw him in with the refugees.
And how would a FEMA director avoid that?
He would give Daniel permission to go out on a mission and then send them on a solo mission where they would be disposed of quietly.
That's pretty specific, but yeah, he'd probably do something like that.
He just did that a couple of days ago. I took the uniform to Daniel as his birthday present.
Then the wheels are already in motion. She can't go out on that mission. The Resistance needs her, especially without William. She can lead the people to freedom.
That's a tall order for one little lady.
She can do it. You know she can. We're going to get Cassie out at the same time. Somehow we need them in the same place. We'll only get one shot at this. Will you help us?
I will. I'll figure out something.
Come with us. Join the Mercs.
I can't, Virgis. Someone has to stay here. To help stop the corrupt slave trade and keep the tabs on the feds.
The invitation stands if you change your mind. I've got to get back. Staff Sergeant Bingham will know the plans. Coordinate your move with him.
Thanks for stopping by and listening to the Changing Earth audio drama. Hope you enjoyed the adventure. This content is copyrighted in 2021 by author Sarah F. Hathaway. For a list of performers, music, and noise attributes, head on over to www.authorsarahfhathaway.com/changingearth. That's www.authorsarahfhathaway.com/changingearth. Special thanks to Zapsplat, freesound.com, and freemusicarchives.com for all the work that they do providing great resources for free music and sounds. Without them, this project would not be possible. Much love to all of my volunteer performers who put hours in designing the characters that you love. We'll see you next time on the Changing Earth audio drama.
Teach the world to be